says it is karma. So out of in original incarnation is one of the first incarnation, Minapa, Maschalpa. We are seeing the son of Jayadeva Goswami. So there it is said, past verse, Praya Priyanti Daletu Tomana Sibidam. Station when Vedas are all drawn like water, that first station is complete Pralaya. At that time you assume very wonderful peace form. Protected the Vedas. I give my presence to you, but you glorify. This is the meaning of that past bhasa, dasavatastha. Tenth canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, 40th chapter. There is prayer by Uddhava, Uddhava Stuti. In that prayer, Uddhava has offered prayers. Namakar namasyaya palayati charaya chara. Payasesne namastudyam madhukaitava mityabe. Adhuparaya vrati nama mandavadhani. Hidurdhara vyaraya nama sukaram. Uddhava says, O Supreme Lord, you have given wonderful peace all and moving in the that water of Pralaya. You are God above all this and highest years of avatar. You give Madhukaitava, so I pay my obeisance to you, O Lord Bhagavan. In your tortoise incarnation, the big tortoise incarnation, you have put that Mandar mountain on your back. Four incarnation, wonderfully. You have lifted the earth from that Pralaya. Water, I am paying my patiences unto you, the Lord. Again, this is 10th canto, 40th chapter. 10th canto, 2nd chapter, you will find also. That is also mentioned. Masyaswaka Sabanur Singha, Varao Hansa, Radhanya Vipra Vibhuti Iskruta Avatar, Tumpasi, नस्त्री भुवनं च तथा भुवनेश भारं उपहर तदुत्तम बंधनं ते जदुत्तम बेस्ट ऑफ जदु डायनेस्टी यो वाच्यं फार्मा मत्स्य फीस कर्म टाटाइस बराह बहु अयग्रीव नृसिंह अंश वामन बलराम रामचंद्र बुद्ध कल्कि आदि लीलावतार जमीन मंदिर अवतार लीलावतार रिलीव मदरात बटन I be my questions again and again to you. The Lagbhaya Tanruta, Rukhru Swamiya say, Paravastha Vatara Sarvunyam Paripurita. Understood? Rukhru Swamiya says in Paravastha Vatara, That Lord, Supreme Lord, in whom these six Aishwarya opulences, types of opulences are composed of four. What are those? Six of Aishwaryas. And?
Beauty, knowledge, strength, finance.
All opulence, all power, strength, prowess. All him, Joseph, all beauty, all knowledge, all renunciation, Virajya. So, the Lord Supreme Lord in whom all these six qualities of all ancestors are four, they are known as Paramasthavata. Nrisimha, Ramachandra and Krishna. These six opulences are four. Do you understand? So these three are known as Paravastha Avatar. Nrisimha, Ramachandra, Krishna. Nrisimha and Ram and Krishna, out of these three, Paravastha Avatar, Krishna is superior, supermost. Krishna is the Bhagavan Swayam. In Bhagavatamrita, Rupa Goswami has quoted Billva Mangala's statement, Santavatara bhava puskarana avasya sarvata bhadra krishnadanya bhava avatasvapi bhimad bhavati. Though this incarnation of taddhanava,
Padmanabha,
a lotus flowers with stem, that's Padmanabha, that is Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, isn't it? That's Padmanabha, it's known as Padmanabha. All incarnations come from him, do you understand? Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, all the Rav are there, that come from him. Though all these avatars come from you, still Krishna Ananya Kova Avatar Swami from Prema Bhagavati, who gives Prema except Krishna? Even Krishna gives Prema to the creeper, not to speak of others. So this is the special characteristic of Krishna Avatar. Those these three are Paravastha Avatar, Nrisimha, Ram and Krishna. You can understand the demons, those are killed by Ram and Nrisimha, have not gotten liberation. You understand? They have not gotten liberation. They are again born in K within the family. The demons were killed by Krishna, even what was because healing, even those who were killed in the presence of Krishna, they all got up. Yes. This is the special characteristic of Krishna. Though these three, Nrisimha Rama and Krishna Parashurama. Those who are thought of Krishna in some way or other, they have all gotten mukti. As for example, Kansa. Kansa was always thinking of Krishna as a peer, Vayavatara. Kansa was known as Vayavatara. He was always thinking of Krishna out of fear. Dreaming condition, sleeping condition. Yeah. Your moment thinking of Krishna. Yeah, hey Krishna. Okay, comes and kills me like this. Shishupal, Vesha of enmity. He was killed. And he got mukti also. Krishna is the only object of love. Those who develop your love have to speak of him. Forget Krishna. Mukti, rose are their feet. Krishna is all beautiful. He is sweet. Kandarpukoti kamaniya vishesa shobham. His beauty far excels that of rose of feet. So Krishna. So here, Parikshit Maharaj inquires about Matsyavatara, fish incarnation. The fish incarnation came two times in two kalpas. Two times in two kalpas. The first kalpa, Swayambhuva Manvantara, at the end of Swayambhuva Manvantara, Matsyavatara came and killed the demon Hayagriva and delivered Vedas. Second time, second kalpa, in Chakshusa Manvantara, the end of Chakshusa Manvantara, this peace incarnation came. And that incarnation is our mercy in King Satyabrata. You understand? So I think this incarnation, what here inquired, it is so immersive to Satya Prabha, isn't it? Yes, King Satya Prabha. This is the second incarnation, Matsyavatara, Sukadeva Goswami. It is so immersive to Satya Prabha. Isn't it?
In both he is saving the Vedas, in both avatars there is a flood. Flood is there.
Then Asavatara, Vayasir Savatara, head is horse head. You understand? Known as Asavatara, Vayagriva, Vayasir Savatara. You understand? Two. Lagvāra says, Sri Sakyat Jagya Purusha. Like Jagya Purusha is Jagya Purusha. He appeared from the Jagya performed by Brahma, Hayasir Sapa, or say, you understand? His bodily complexion was, his like golden complexion. His whole body is Veda, full of Vedas. Then higher Griva, higher Sesa, higher Griva too. This higher Griva avatar also appeared from the Jagya of Brahma. He killed Bhagavan Kaitava to demons. You understand? This higher Griva. Also, he delivered Vedas, killing us to demons, delivered Vedas. Kachava avatar, tortoise incarnation, Kurma avatar, also came in two times. This avatar comes two times. You know? In the beginning of Kalpa, he came. Carried the Earth, Mother Earth. Then he again came in Chakshusa Manvantara when there are tuning of the milk ocean combined by demigods and demons. And he carried the Mandara mountain, you understand, was put on his back. That is touch two times. Nrisingha avatar came in Chakshusa Manvantara. That is description of man. Bhagavatam here Nrisingha avatar. This Hiranyakashipu protected Ujjati body. Then Varahavatar, born in condition, came once two times. Brahmakalpa, in Swayambhuva Manvantara, he came out from the nostrils of Brahma, isn't it? And he lifted Prithivi, Mother Earth from Papa and carriages, so carriages, isn't it? Second time in Chakshusa Manvantara, Brahma also lifted Mother Earth from this pralaya water. And lifted and carried down his white tusk. At that time, Hiranyakasipu's brother, Hiranyakasipu, fought him, isn't it? Varahavatar killed him. Sometimes Varahavatar was four legs, sometimes Nurgara, two legs, half Vara, half human part, Nurgara. Sometimes black, sometimes white. Therefore, Krishna Varaha, Sita Varaha, you say. And Hansavatara, Ilagavayatam, let us say. Kao is the cow destroys everything. In the course of time, everything is destroyed. This cow, time factor. In Gita, 11th chapter, we find Krishna shows his gigantic universal form here, universal form to Arjuna. Arjuna gets terrified, frightened. And he asked, Kavaram Pramuti. Bhagavan Pramuti, who are you, so fearful for? Supreme Lord says, Kalasmin Loka Kevaspatipa. I am Kala. I am the time. I come to destroy them. Yes, by destroys it. Time destroys. In course of time, everything is destroyed. So in course of time, when this jiva tattva, bhakti, yoga, tattva, jnana, everything is lost. So Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, appeared from the water in the form of Hansa, Swami. And he instructed this tattva jnana, imparted tattva jnana, all the munis headed by Narada. You understand? Hansa has some special characteristic. It can, how to say, if you mix milk and water, the Hansa can separate it. You understand? Sun can separate it. Radhanya Avatara, that Radhan means king incarnation, that's the Lord Ram, who recently was well. Azar Ram, appearance of Lord Ram, Ram has to be. This is Radhanya Avatara, king incarnation. Vajasodhamantara, Chaturdhinsa, Chaturjuva, Treta Juva, Lord Ram came as the son of Dasarath Maharaj. He appeared in four parts. Ram, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna. Four parts. In that avatar he killed Ravan and built a bridge. See Shiv Bandha, Raman, TV, Mayans. They must say. According to Skanda Puran, this Ram, Lakshman, Bharata, Shatrughna, they are four quadruples. Shatrughna. Ram is Vasudev, Lakshman is Sankarsana, Bharata is Pradyumna, Shatrughna is Anuruddha. Bodily complexion of Ram and Bharata, Shyam Varna.
Shyam.
Shyam. Blue. You understand? It's cloud. Cloud. Body combination of Lakshmana and Shatrughna, golden hue. You understand? Different types of incarnations are there. Viravatar, Gunavatar, Prasavatar, Nandantaravatar, Satyaveshavatar, Jugavatar, six types. So Jugavatar, in every Juga, Jugavatar comes, isn't it? Satya, Treta, Dvapa, Kali. Four jugas, jugavatar comes. Satya juga or jugavatar? Who?
What's it?
Hansa. You understand? Bodily complexion is white, suitable, 400 fast. He has put on matted hair in his head. His sacred thread is made up of the skin of Krishna Sarabhula, deer. You understand? And he puts on Rudra Kamala. He holds danda and water for commander. This is Satya Juga. In Satya Juga, human beings are very peaceful. Nature, no enmity, all friendly, equal vision, develop equal vision. They undergo tapasya. You understand? Through tapasya, Ruti Ratna. had Vishnu meditation, tapasya. They approached Vishnu. So names are, though that Satya Yuga, the names of Bhagavan is Hansa, Subarna, Vaikuntha, Dharma, Jagyeshwara, Amara, Ishwara, Purusha, Abhyakta, Paramatma. These are the names of Bhagavan, that Yuga, Satya Yuga. Then Treta Yuga. Treta Yuga, Yugavatar, Rakta Varna, bodily complexion is blood.
Rakta
red.
Red.
Reddish. He is 400 from Pingala Kesa. Hair and his head. The color of the hair is copper. Copper color. What is that? Have you seen copper?
Reddish.
Yes, slight red. Copper color. Pingala Kesa. He has put on a belt, mekhala, that is made up of three vedas, ruksha, jaru. And he holds shruk shrava, that means jaru. That is a letter, for he, shruk shrava. In Jagya Murti. So, human beings, they all worship with love through Jagya. Isn't it? That's what, through Jagya. Supreme Lord is Jagya Murti. His names in Treta Yuga are Vishnu, Jagya, Makhabhuma. You understand? Dvapar Yuga, Yugavatar, bodily complexion of Yugavatar Syam Varna. Syam Varna. He puts on yellow garment. He is 400 for carrying Sankha Chakra Dada Padvan. And there is Srivastha. And the chest. Yugavar. Deep lower seat. Up lower seat to temple lower seat. Tantra Vidhan. And special Dwapar, Swayam Rupa Bhagavan comes. Special Dwapar. And Krishna is born Swarup comes in special Dwapar. Just like the Buddha special Dwapar, this God is special God. Mahaprabhu comes in special God, special Dwapar. Original Bhagavan is Swarup. Krishna comes. Krishna Swarup Bhagavan. Swayam. So when Krishna comes, so Yuga Avatar comes. Krishna is the source of all incarnation. Krishna comes, all avatars are there. So Yuga Avatar is there. So he not only, what do you say, introduces Yuga Dharma, but also releases his own prema. Bhikta Purusar Krishna Prema. That is special. So Satya Treta Dwapar, three Yugas, Yugavatar come, Yugavatars come and propagate Yuga Dharma. And they are worshipped. In Kali Yuga, the same principle. So this special Kali, this is special Kali Yuga. After special Dwapar comes special Kali. So Swayam Rupa Bhagavan comes as Gaurav Swarupa. And he distributes indiscriminately this Krishna Prema to one and all, even patita farmers. Krishna Varanam, Srisar Krishna, Sangopangastra Parsadam, Jaggi Sankirtan Prahi, Jadanti Sumedasa. Krishna Varanam, Srisar Krishna, Sangopangastra Parsadam, Jaggi Sankirtan Prahi, Jadanti Sumedasa.
Made of Kali, those people who are endowed with sufficient brain substance, they will worship the Lord who is coming to distribute his own name and is accompanied by his own angas, his own limbs in the form of his companions, and they will be, the worship will be done through Nam Sankirtan.
Yeah. Krishna Varna. Varna means letter, Varna means color.
Krishna, not Krishna.
Do you understand? Krishna Varnam Tuisharas Sangha Pangastra Parsad Jagge Sankirtanpari Jadanti Sumedasa. Varna alphabet letter, Varna color, different meanings. So, different meanings also here. Krishna is true letter. This, he does Kirtan, is Krishna Kirtan. Understand? Comes and does this Kirtan, Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Through this Kirtan, he inculcates Krishna consciousness. Others, all, you understand, and gives Krishna prema. This Kirtan. So, Anga Upanga Astra Parsada, he comes. He comes with main limb, Anga. Who is Anga? His limb.
His associates, Panchatattva.
Nityananda Adyaita. Do you understand? Nityananda Prabhu, Adyaita Prabhu, his limb, Anga. Upanga, sublimb. Oh, are sublimbs.
Gadadhar and Srivas Pandit. Gadadhar Pandit, Srivas Pandit.
Srivas, yes. All the pure devotees headed by Srivas. Do you understand? It's Upanga. Sanga Upanga Astra is weapon. What is his weapon?
His preachers.
Harinam. Harinam and Shastra. Shastra is Shastra. Shastra means weapon. Harinam and Shastra is weapon. Do you understand? Anga Upanga Astra Parsada is associates. Who are Parsada?
Sadhu Damodar Goswami?
Yes.
Rai Ramananda?
Yes. Gadadhar, Damodar Swarup, Ramananda, Sanatana, Rupa, all these are persons, etc. So comes. And again another meaning, Anta Krishna Bahir Gaura. This Krishna Varna, black is your inside, outside is yellowish or whitish. Bahir Gaura, Anta Krishna Bahir Gaura. Jim Radha Bhava Dviti, the mood of Radharani and bodily complexion of Radharani, that Gaurav, Gaurav Sundar, learned persons, intelligent, wise persons, they offer worship this Supreme Lord, Sankirtan Jagya, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Harir-nama, harir-nama, eva kevalam, kalam nasti, eva nasti, eva nasti, eva harir-nama, harir-nama, eva kevalam, kalam nasti, eva nasti, eva nasti, eva nasti, eva nasti. In Kali Yuga, there is no other way, no other way, no other way. Harir-nama, eva kevalam, only to accept, take shelter of. Harinam. You understand? Take shelter of Harinam. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Nasteva, 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 Nasteva. Three times said, not way, not way, not way. Three things are condemned. Karma, Jnana, Yoga. You understand? Therefore, two things, and there is importance, stress, harinams. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Rama. Therefore, the Harinam Sankirtan is Yuga Dharma. Prabhu kahe kahe lama, e mahamantra. Yaha dhapadhyā, pariyānupanda, yaha hoite, sabasiddhi, vaiveshava, sarvakhyana laite, jivinaya. Mahaprabhu said, I tell you this mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. This is Mahamantra, this is Taraka Brahma Nam, known as Taraka Brahma Nam of Kali Yuga. This is the Japya Mantra. Chanting, we chant with our beads. Japya Mantra and Kirtanya, also Kirtan. Both Japya Mantra and Kirtan. You understand one mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Yaha Japya Kriya. Yavitya Sarvasiddhi Hoiveshava. You will get all perfection and supreme perfection because you give Krishna Prema. Sarvakhyan Varaite Vidhinaya. Always say, always incidentally chant Avishranta Nama. No restrictions there. You understand? Freedom all. Any place, any time, any condition, whatever condition it may be, no restriction. Give us chant. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. You understand? This is Kali Yuga. So people of Kali Yuga are very fortunate because they get such Taraka Brahma Nam, which Mahamantra, and which gives Krishna prema. And Mahaprabhu comes. Krishna himself comes in the form of Mahaprabhu and distributes Krishna prema indiscriminately, one and all, even Tamaras, most degraded, devas, Jagai Madhas. Take it from the speaker of us. Even Yuga has Taraka Brahma. You understand? So, what is the Taraka Brahmana of Satya Yuga?
You gave it in one newsletter, we have it, but we have not remembered.
Taraka Brahmana, as this Kali Yuga Taraka Brahmana, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, this is Taraka Brahmana. Similarly, what is Taraka Brahma Nama of Satya Yuga?
Narayana Paramir.
Yes. Narayana Paravita, Narayana Parakshara, Narayana Paravutti, Narayana Paragati. This is Taraka Brahma Nama of Satya Yuga. What? Renomati is its pervert. Huh? Narayana, yes. Have you written it?
It is written.
Written?
It is written. Newsletter?
Newsletter. Oh. Yes. Done is one. So read it, read it.
You read.
You read. Yes.
That means Narayan is abode of all Vigyan, language, yes. Mukti, liberation and ultimate goal.
Yes.
This is Aishwarya Gata Nam.
Yes.
Not Madhurya.
Not Madhurya.
All opulence.
Yes.
And it only gives Dasya Bhav. No other Bhav or Melon.
Yes. This much?
This much.
Yes. Narayana is the abode of Vijnana, Bhasa, Mukti, and Sarangati. You understand? This is Aishwarjagatana, not Madhurjagatana. Narayana, name of Narayana is Aishwarjagatana, Madhurjagatana. So, Vaikuntha, Narayana is in Vaikuntha. This is only Dasya Bhava is there in Vaikuntha. There are 2.5 males. Two and a half. Santo, Dasya, Apsakya. Only 2.5 males in Vaikuntha. So this, the purport of this Sarva Brahmanam, you know, Dasya Bhava. Santo is there, Santaros is there, Rasya is there, Apsakya is there. This Sakya means friendship with all reverence, nothing else. Then Dharva Brahmanam of Tribhajuna, Rama Narayana Mantam Kunda Madhusudana, Krishna Kesava Kansare Hare Hare Kundavan. This is Dharva Brahmanam of Tridhajana. The purpose, this is what he has given, read it.
This mantra in Tridhajana gives complete Asya, some glimpse of Sakya Bhava. It is also Aishwarya Gata.
Yes.
And it contains wonderful Vikram or potencies.
Yes.
But not much.
This much. Yeah, that's all right. Rama, Narayana, Ananta, Mukunda, Madhusudana, Kesava, Kamsara, Hare, Vaikuntha, Vamana. All these names. Of these names, Aishwarya Gata, opulence. You understand? These are the names of Lord Narayana. Sampurna Dasyaras is there, little Sakya is there. Understand? So Tarka Brahma Nama Dvapar Juga. Hare Murari Madhukaita Bhari Gopal Govinda Mukunda Sarve Jagyesa Narayana Krishna Vishnu Nirasrima Jagadisa Raksha. This is Tarka Brahmana Dvapachiva. So the names here in this Tarka Brahmana Nirasrima Jagadisa Raksha. It's all point out Krishna. You understand? Hare Murare Madhukaitavare Gopal Govinda Mukunda Sarve Jagyesa Narayana Krishna Vishnu Nirasrayama Jagadishara. You understand? Those are helpless, unprotected, Krishna will give them protection. So it's all point out Krishna. In these names there is four rasas, four mellows. Santa, Dasya, Sakya, Dasya. No prema. No madhuryas. You understand? Four verses. Understand? But in Kalijuga Tarka Nama, best of all. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Best of all. It is madhurya for all. Yes, it is madhurya. It contains everything, all mellows. When there is question of prema, mukhya pati jiva pai, Krishna prema. Chief result of chanting is Hare Krishna mantra. Hey Krishna prema. You understand me? Krishna prema. When the Krishna prema is there, one can develop Krishna. Prema bhakti, pure bhakti. So mukti is rolling at his feet. Mukti is rolling. Mukti mukulkandari sevatyasthan samayapati kya. Mukti stands at his doorstep. Folded hands with standing there in those days, folded hands, was saying this Hare Krishna and demonstration of prema. Ah, this is this Kali Yuga. Lord Brahma Naam, Madhurya Paro, very sweet, Madhurya Hari Naam, Nectarian, sweet, and it is Madhurya Ras is here. All rasas in Kostina Madhurya Ras is there, all rasas, Santa Dasa Satya Vasa, every rasa, all rasas are there, the topmost rasa, Madhurya Ras is there. So those who are intelligent, wise persons, they will take this chanting of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Mahaprabhu says, Nam Nam Kari Kaudhari Sattva Sakti Tattral Pitanya Mena Smarani Naka Veta Prasi Sava Kripa Bhavana Mahapi Dhritte Vidrusi Mihadri Nam Raga. So merciful you are, O Lord. Yetadrushi Tava Kripa. You give all the potencies here in your this name, holy name. Even the highest attainment is their highest. That is, Krishna Prema is there, Sarva Satya potency is there, Durdeva Hindus, no Kaaniyam, there is no restriction of time, place and circumstance, any time, any place, any circumstance, any condition, one can chant. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Such merciful you are. Durdeva Hindusi Mahavani Narva, I am such a Durdeva rascal. I cannot develop attraction for you.
Interest for
you? Yes. No interest, no attraction for you. And Durdeva Hindusi. So those who are wise and intelligent person, they must take to this. Their wife, they will get all, everything, all the jobs. Bhagavatam, her kind of. Kapladeva Uti Sambhalsi. अहो मतस्वतिकमकृतनामकृतपस्ते जो सस्म आर्या ब्रह्मूर्च नाम पीजते अहो मतस्वतिकमकृतनामकृत ओ लॉर्ड एंड द टीप्स ऑफ हू स्ट्रांग योर होली नेम डांसेस यू अंडरस्टैंड ही बिकम्स गुरु. He may be born in Chandav and yes, so Patanjali. Yes. He may be born in Chandav and Dagi Tarpan still away chants, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
He becomes good. Yes. So Patanjali, you have never seen a put of a state, a put of a state, Jesus, as a human, Mamma. He gets given. He gets the result of undergoing tapasya. Yes. Isn't it? Understand my language? Tapasya. Penance must be deep. Why? Why shall one undergo austerity penance? Now tapasya sikamteya tatkarsa marapani. Isn't it? In Gita Krishna Sikam. Tapasya sikamteya. Apart from the topic of tapasya to me, that means one should undergo tapasya to get Krishna only. No other purpose. But demons undergo very severe type of tapasya for what purpose? To get material, power, opulence, and so on. And to satisfy Brahma Shiva. Demigods. Tapasya is a mean for satisfying Krishna and the world jobs for the Krishna. Forget Krishna. That's tapasya kongya to Krishna mother. Nāpa kata rāsa. Arādhita dhati hari tapasya tata ki. Nārādhita dhati hari tapasya tata ki. Antarvahi dhati hari tapasya tata ki. Nāntarvahi dhati hari tapasya tata ki. Understand?
If Vedas tell it deity is performed, you don't get Hari, what is the use?
Yes, Araditam the Hari Tapasatabhati. If Lord Hari is being worshipped, then what is the need of tapasya? Because the aim of tapasya, purpose of tapasya to get Lord Hari and Krishna. And engage in his loving worship and service. What they need of the Sahari? Nara is only Hari Tapasatva, the Lord Hari is not worthy. What they need of the Sahari? Antarvaya the Hari Tapasatva, the King and Antarvaya the Hari Tapasatva, the King. If someone sees Lord Hari Krishna within and without, then what they need of the Sahari? If someone cannot see Lord Hari Krishna within and out, then what is the need of the Krishna? Understand? That is not the Panchalatya says. So, one who chants this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, accepting Nama Tattva with Guru, and taking shelter of Nam Tattva with Guru, accept his name, his chants, his guidance, and his chanting is pure, offenseless, he gets prema, he gets Krishna. So where is the need of tapasya? No need. He gets all the result of tapasya already there. No need of tapasya. What tapasya you can do in Kalijuga? Submit. Rayan or Pai, Sakala, Vasvin, Chukijana, Manda, Mandis, Manda, Mandis, Manda, Manda, Bhagya, Yuva, Tuta. Short span of life, getting shorter, shorter, shorter due to sinful activities, sinful reactions and influence in Kali Yuga. What sort of purpose, what sort of thing I can do? Just chant Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram, Ram,
Hare. And get all the result of this. People come as the Jehovah. One chants this Hare Krishna, holy name of Krishna. He gets all this jhana performing of Vedic sacrifices. No need of any Vedic sacrifice. In Kali Yuga only one sacrifice is recommended, this Hari Nam Jagya, isn't it? Yes. But some fools are there that doing some other jhana. Some advertisement has come out in paper and stuff. I saw they are doing some horse sacrifice or Sumit Jagya here in Bhubaneswar. Oh yes.
Oh yeah, I saw some.
Yes.
Some advertisement in the city.
Yes. Horse sacrifice. So fools. In Kali Yuga, not the Jagya is recommended only. Hare Nam Yuga Keval only. Hare Nam Jagya. Asumedam Gavalambam. Sanyasam Kala Paitrukam. Kala Paitrukam. Sanyasam Devarena Putratpati. Kalo Pancha Vigurjita. In Kali Yuga, five things are forbidden. Asamedam Gavalambam. Sanyasam Kala Paitrukam. Devarena Putratpati. Asamedam Jagya, Har Sacrifice. Gavalambam. Kao Sacrifice Jagya. Asamedam Gavalambam. Kala Paitrukam. Kala Paitrukam offering meat in Pitru Shraddha. You follow me? Other jugas they are offering meat, meat of the deer, meat of the rhinoceros, ganda. Yes, they are offering other jugas, but in Kali Yuga it's forbidden. Kala Paitrukam, sannyasam, this is karma sannyasam. That Mahabharata sannyasam, they take karma sannyasam, ek danda, they hold one danda. That sannyasa is forbidden. Vaishnava sannyasa, Siddhanti sannyasa, not forbidden. That. Karma sannyasa, they say, we have no karma, we have given up everything. All is to sit down and meditate and like this in Himalayan cave. Yes, that's Himalayan cave. No activity, no karma. We have karma sannyasa, given up all karma. But your karma should be done. Forbidden. Satisfaction, pleasure of Krishna. Yes. And Vaishnava sannyasi is not karma sannyasi, is engaged in loving service of Krishna every time. That's right. He is often doing now to offer more and more and more service. Travels, goes here and there. there throughout the world, speaks, preaches about so many things. You understand? That real sannyasa. Sannyasa, what is real sannyasa? What do you mean by that? Follow? What do you mean by that? What is real sannyasa?
Even I'm acting for one's satisfaction and acting only for Krishna's satisfaction. Kayo mana vakya.
Yes, yes. Anukkhana hari bhajan. Understand my language? Constantly chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. Is that a sannyas? Constantly chanting Hari Nam, that is sannyas. Hari bhajan. I'm constantly engaged in rendering loving service to Lord Hari, that is sannyas. You understand? His sannyas means he gives up, he renounces what? Bhukti and bhukti. Sannyas means renunciation. You understand me? Renounce. Renounce what? Bhukti and bhukti. Material enjoyment and liberation. That is real renunciation, sannyas. Understand? The Vaishnava sannyas. The Vaishnavas, bhaktas, they have renounced these desire for material enjoyment, desire for liberation, and have taken shelter at the lotus feet of Goddess Bhakti completely. They are real sannyas. Understand? This is a real sannyas. Are you? Are you? Who like heart? This is a real sannyas. Understand? That is says. Tebu tapaste juhu. That's the all the sort of the form of giving sacrifices. Yes, I was saying. Five things are forbidden in Kali Yuga. Asvamedham, Gavalambham, Sannyasam. This sannyas. Karma sannyas. It's forbidden. Papaitrugam, offering meat in Itusrada, and Devarena Putrupati. Fifth one. Understand? To produce progeny. Children, putra, son,
The woman wants brother's wife.
Through the brother of your husband. You understand? The woman. Still it's going on, but it's forbidden. Suppose the husband dies of the woman. You understand? The husband dies. Husband of the woman dies. So, she accepts the younger brother of that husband and produces children. You understand? Deva. They were the younger brother of the husband, Deva. You understand? Even your country is not. She accepts so many husbands. One after another. No such restriction. But here in India, we have this system. If the husband dies, then wife accepts the younger brother of the husband and produces children. They were not this forbidden in Kali Yuga. Yes, it's forbidden in Kali Yuga. Yes. This is not a genetic process. These five things are forbidden. They were still it's going on. Prostitution going on. So things are going on. Yes. Because people don't follow the Vedic regulations. Vedic regulations don't follow. So we, the Vaishnavas, we follow it. Srila Prabhupada has given instructions. If husband dies, the wife should not marry. If she has come to this life, Mahaprabhu's life, accepted Vaishnava Guru, become Vaishnavi. Husband dies, son of again married. No. Remain just life. Just. Human just. Nonsense. Strict life. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. You understand Mahaprabhu has sung it. Mahaprabhu can teach us how to do it. Mahaprabhu took up sannyas at very young age, at the age of 24. First wife, Lakshmipriya, dead. Then accepted second wife, Mahaprabhu. Because his mother, Sati Mata, again cried. Mahaprabhu even was, no mother, I become worse by state. Because his young brother, Vishwarupa, didn't marry, left home to look sannyas. So Sati Mata cried. Mahaprabhu said, no mother, don't cry. I'll become grosto, I'll marry her second wife and stay. So first wife then died. First wife died, Lakshmipriya, then again Sati Mata cried. So please his mother, Mahaprabhu's second wife, Vishnupriya. You understand? Second wife. Recently married, young wife, yes. Young wife recently married. But took up sannyas. Took up sannyas. At the age of 24. Young wife recently come. Recently. And old mother. Mother is old. Huh? Mother is old. Wife is young. Yes. She took up sannyas. Left. Then what did Vishnupriya did do? She was young, very young. Did she marry? She didn't marry. You understand? She didn't marry. How she lived life? Don't know. Don't know. Huh?
Extreme penance.
Extreme penance. What is that? Extreme penance. You say. What is that? What is that?
I was told that she was chanting constantly, and every time she chant one round, she put one grain of rice.
Yes.
And when she has finished, she eat only that much rice.
Yeah. That's a good follow up what it says. Extreme penance, late such a life. When Mahaprabhu took up sannyas, leaving, Mahaprabhu leaving, living home. So Sati Mata cried. Vishnupriya also cried. Mahaprabhu left Vishnupriya that night. You saw that the story? You might sannyas that day. This night left Vishnupriya. Slipped up. Yes. So in Chaitanya Mangal it is said, mentioned, just we have to the eve of his leaving for sannyas, Mahaprabhu said when Sati Mata cried and why he cries. Kinari puru soaro kiva karo poti kinari puru soaro Shri Krishna Charana Vinu Aro Nahi Gati
Shri Krishna Charana Vinu
Aro Nahi Gati Sei Pita Sei Mata Sei Bandhu Jana
Sei Pita Sei Mata
সেই কর্তা সেই মাত্র ধরম
সেই কর্তা সেই কর্তা সেই মাত্র ধরম
পুত্র স্নেহ করমতী नारी की पुरुष और केवा का पति व्हाट इज वुमन व्हाट इज मैन मेल और फीमेल हु इज वन हस्बैंड हु इज वन वाइफ हु इज वन सन हु इज वन मदर श्री कृष्ण तरुण मेल नहीं आम गति ओनली वन एम वन गोल इज the lotus feet of Krishna. Yes. That is the supreme goal. The lotus feet of Krishna. No other goal is there. Say pita, say mata, say bandhujana. That Krishna is father, Krishna is mother, Krishna is friend, Krishna is the protector, Krishna is the maintainer, Krishna is the wealth, asset, everything is Krishna. पुत्र स्नेह करम ते ततमड़ भाव श्री कृष्ण जन हेले कत होला तो मदर डेवलपर्स अफेक्शन लव एंड अफेक्शन टू मी एंड द सन इफ यू डेवलप दैट लव एंड अफेक्शन टुवर्ड्स कृष्णा यू विल गेट सच इमेंस गेन जस्ट समलाइज रिडायरेक्ट दैट लव एंड अफेक्शन टुवर्ड्स कृष्णा ओ मदर सही से परम बंधु सही पिता माता
सही से परम बंधु सही पिता माता
श्री कृष्ण शरण ले प्रेम भक्ति नाथ
श्री कृष्ण शरण ले प्रेम कृष्ण गुरु नहीं मिले
जन्म खाइले विनाश पाए भाई व्हाट जनरल सन व्हाट एन ऑर्डिनरी सन डस
ही गोस टू अर्न सम मनी
ही गोस आउट ऑन मनी हां कलेक्ट सम मनी अर्न सम मनी सम गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर इजंट इट So if you have it, the earning of that sun, that money, gold and silver, you'll be destroyed. Oh mother, you cannot achieve Paradharma, Supreme Dharma. You understand? Dhana upadhan kare ani bada dukkha, dhana jagukya apuni marukha. While going out for earning money, toils very hard. You understand? Like an ass, day and night, yes. Thus, like an ass, day and night to earn money, 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 money. Brighter than sunshine, sweeter than honey. Get so much suffering, trouble, faces so much danger, calamity. Sometimes he's stabbed, he's killed. Yes, isn't it? Such consequences. Sometimes loses his dharma, his wealth, or loses his life also. Yes, so trouble is there. Isn't it? But I am going out to earn a dharma, some wealth. That is what? Krishna prema hinavana. Do you understand? I will bring Krishna prema. The dhana, the asset, the wealth, in the form of Krishna prema. So-called sampadvai, that is the source of all types of wealth. Krishna prema, I'll bring that dhana to you. Oh mother, why are you crying? I'm going out for that dhana. Understand? Mahaprabhu says, so-called sampadvai, Krishna prema. The lotus feet of Krishna is the source of all sorts of assets, wealth. Yes, I bring that to you. Why I cry? No sun does so. Ordinary sun does so. I am going to bring you that one. Sakatam Nitita Mata Samutpai. Krishna Pranayamita Vittari. In all paths, if the body gets father and mother, that father and mother can come here. But such a father and mother who gives Krishna prema bhakti, nobody gets. Very rare. Only one gets. You understand? So I have accepted such guru, father and mother, that give me this mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. God of Chinese, it's Krishna Prema, you know. Holy name gives you. Ekun tapaste, juhu, sasnu. You get all this thought of. So I was saying, this Vishnu Priya, yes, sitting man, young lady, recently married, very young, in such, life's late, very austere life, austere, and such pronounce, constantly chants Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Sits down and chants, puts two atom, small atom pots. In one pot there is some rice and another empty pot. As we chant once Hare Krishna and brings down one bead in our this counting beads. Isn't it? Similarly, she puts one grain of rice in that. You understand? So day and night 24 hours chants as long as she can chants. As long as she can stand and puts rice. One grain of rice. So, at the end of the day or evening or something, right? gets up from her seat, the whatever rice is not scented, he cooks the rice and only takes the food. That is the food. Huh? She led such life. Young lady, listen here. Huh? Such a clear life. Huh? But what do you do? A life my husband dies, I like so another. Yes. There is your chastity. There is your chastity, Baba. Unchastity. Prostitutions. Chastity is the force. You understand? Chastity is the power. Potency of the lady. Just lady, so many stories are there. Just lady was there who could check off, could check the rising of the sun. Say, no, sun would not rise. Sun didn't rise. Yes. Such. Yes, strength. Strength, power, just it is. Yes. That muni cast, Madhukya muni, that's a light. When sun will rise, your husband will die. You'll become widow. That's just like said, Allah, what is that? If I'm real chest, my mind, body and speech and real chest, I say sun will never rise, my husband never die. And that happened. Sun didn't rise. Sun didn't rise, yes. It's checked out. Such a force of chest lady. You have such chastity nowadays, ladies? Not just. Then there is problem for Brahma. Oh, my creation will be now destroyed if sun will not rise. What happened? What happened? What happened? The Brahma meditated, oh, that's just lady. Just lady has said that thing. Sit down. The rising of the sun, so Brahma came to that just lady. The another just lady of Anusuya, wife of Atrimu. Wife of Atrimuni was Anusuya's chest lady. One snap came to test his chastity, her chastity, her chastity. You understand? Snap came and singing Veena, Narayana, Narayana, Hare Krishna, and taking arms. So Atrimuni was not there at that time, gone out. So Anusuya was there, chest lady. Came up alive, Munivar. Take arms. No, no, I am on condition. What is that? If you come naked and give arms, then I will accept. All right. What is that? Come naked. I, lady will come naked before another male. Only it says lady becomes naked before her husband. She cannot become naked. The male. Justice is spoiled. Then said, but Nanda has come to chest. Test her chest. This is my condition. Otherwise I won't accept, let me go away. So then he'll be offended. This guest went away. Then I will offend her. Agrastha dharma is spoiled. So what to do? Nanda Muni has this condition. Then shut up. Just lady also, one is such a just lady, she's a dear devotee. The Lord and Lord gives the real intelligence. So she had came to the feet washing water of her husband. Every morning she gets up and washes the feet of her husband, gives that water, brings it to him. Just lady, yes. Gets up, goes down, washes the feet. Husband, Savaipati. Husband is Lord Sukhutva. You understand? Just ladies. It's that one. That intelligence came. All light. I'll keep up that condition. Wait. Anusuya said, wait. I'll keep up that condition. I'll come naked. Wait. So she brought that water. not that water. It was some water for husband and sprinkled it over. Narada Muni, immediate Narada Muni turned into a woman. Then Sikhim Nakana like take. Nothing should know. Such is just treaty, you see. Yes, Samasuya. Just why? Yes. To real chest wall, lady, you are such force, strength, potency. Sit down. So, Brahma came with that Anasuya. Of that, just lady, please withdraw your words. Let sun rise, otherwise the whole creation will be destroyed, finished. I cannot withdraw my word because my husband will die. Brahma said, and then Anasuya said, no, your husband will never die. You can live. Then she withdrew her words. Sun arose. His husband died. But Brahma had that water from Kamandala sprinkled in. Husband got a new life, nice life. Young, youthful. Well, such is just man. Vishnu Vyasa, first lady. Said in man. Yes. Man. Who bothered that instruction? It's husband dies, if you are Vaishnavi, ascertain this Vaishnav Dikya and has come to this line. Don't marry. Don't accept another husband. Lead such life. Must be your life. Jai Hare Krishna. Yes. Yes. This is that. So if you chant Hare Krishna, you get all this. Potential there, strength is there. Devu, tapas, tev, juhu. Sasnara, you get the joy of taking bath in all. Tirthas, holy places, no need of going to anything. Arja, all purifications are there, purification ceremonies take place, you become Arja, not an Arja, Ayari. Brahmanacho, that means you get the result of studying all Veda, means you get all Vedic knowledge. Because Naam, holy name, is the source of all Vedic knowledge. It is not different from Krishna. Krishna is the source of Vedic knowledge. From the breath of Krishna. Breath of Supreme Lord, Veda comes. So we chant Hare Krishna. So you get all that information. We chant Hare Krishna. That's everything. Just Hare
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
You thought this is Sravaka Brahma Nama Kalijuga is such. This is this. Other Tara Brahma Nama, other Yugas are not such.
Hare Krishna.
Guru Maharaj?
Yes.
In the Bhagavatam, Lord Krishna says, Tapo Meridayam Sakshat.
Huh?
Tapo Meridayam Sakshat. Austerity is my heart.
Yes.
So why does he say like that?
Hmm?
Why does he say like that?
He also says, Tapo Divyam Putra Kaha Brahma Saukhyam Tu Ananta.
Huh?
Who says?
Rishabhdev
says to his sons, this life is meant for tapasya. Huh? Isn't it? Vidbhujamjay, why are we eating stone? This life is, man life is not meant for eating stone, that is not meant for sense enjoyment. Meant for tapasya. Tapadivyam putraka, brahma saukhyam tananta. What are you asking? This is tapasya in Kali Yuga. Huh? Chant Hare Krishna, follow four regulative principles strictly. That is tapasya. What more tapasya you can do? Do this. Yes. This is the tapasya for Kali Yuga. Huh? Why are you stupid mind thinking of eating stone? Eating stone, yes. One wife dies, accept another wife. One husband dies and accept another husband. Huh? To eat stone. lead the life of austerity, the nuns. Huh? Then? Why eating stone? This is real tapasya. Chant Hare Krishna, strictly follow for regulative principles. Yes. Yet Krishna, the result of tapasya, the aim, goal of tapasya is to get Krishna. The tapasya sikam deyadat purusva madarpanam. Yes.
Why does he say it is my heart? Hridayam sakshat, it is my very heart, Krishna says.
Because you get Krishna is there in the heart. Love is there in the heart. Yes. Krishna, Trivanga Lalita. Huh? Isn't it? Mm-hmm. Three places to get. And very beautiful. Because this crookedness is the monopoly of Krishna. Duplicity is the monopoly of Krishna. Jiva, if imitates, then he becomes duplicious. Jiva imitates Krishna, then he becomes duplicious. Why are you imitating Krishna? Becoming duplicious, why imitating Krishna? Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj says, the duplicity, crookedness, kapatya is monopoly of Krishna. Yes. Do you understand? Three places crooked, not one, two. So, Tama Trivanga Varsyam Sindhu is so beautiful. Huh? But you become three places crooked, always crooked person, ugly looking. You never look beautiful, but it looks so beautiful. Shyam Sundar. Huh? Why three places to get? What is the purpose behind it? Huh?
Breaking three modes of
materiality? No! Three tattvas. Samanda, Abhidhaya, Prayojana. Do you understand? Manifest. Three tattvas. Samanda, Abhidhaya, Prayojana. First is Samanda tattva, second is Abhidhaya tattva, third is Prayojana tattva. Samanda, relationship. Abhidhaya bhakti prayodana prema. Do you understand me? So first break is feet. Like this. Second break is
head.
Mukha. Do you understand? Feet. Left towards Radharani. Third break is heart. First, second, third. Samanda, this is Abhidhaya, this is Prayojana. Prayojana is Prema, Prema is in the heart. Understand? Why he says, my heart? Huh? Understood? Dull head? This is what you should understand this thing. And this is the tapasya in Kali Yuga. To follow for regulative principles, strictly chant Hare Krishna. Yes. What more tapasya can do? No need of going to Himalayan mountains, some solitary place, and stay in a mountainous cave, and no eating, huh? Only vayu ahar, air, breathing air, isn't it? Puraka, rechaka, kumbhaka, pranayam, huh? So, one does so, entering the mountainous cave, noiting, then becomes weaker and weaker and weaker day by day, and puts a block of stone at the mouth of the cave and sits inside the cave. Do you understand? And thus also austerity and tapasya, then become weaker and weaker and weaker. No eating, only Murakareshaka Kumbhaka doing. So it becomes so weak that he cannot come to the mouth and push back the block of stone, cannot come out, will die inside. That is self-suicide. Commit self-suicide.
He becomes a ghost.
Yes!
Fourth of his austerity.
Yes. What is this austerity?
Not prema.
Not prema. Understand me? Understand?
I heard that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta said that the Buddha that people are worshipping today is not the same Buddha.
No, that is not Buddha incarnation. Bhagavata says, Kikateshu. Huh? What Bhagavata says? Kikata. Kikata means in Bihar. Huh? In Bihar there is a place, Gaya, that is Kikata. That Buddha, which is the Lord Vishnu's incarnation, he appeared there, In Kikota?
Not in Nepal.
Not in Nepal. This Buddha appeared and took birth in Nepal in a garden named Lumbini.
That's the one they're worshipping.
Do you understand? And his father's name was Subodhana. Mother's name, so history says. So this is not that Buddha.
So they're not worshipping the Vishnu?
Real incarnation, yes. That Vaishnavas have said. We are Vaishnavas. We don't accept this Buddha's incarnation.
No? So they have no benefit whatsoever?
Why? What benefit is there? It's not incarnation. Lord Vishnu. Yes.
It's like a huge misunderstanding.
Yes, yes. I misunderstand. Then I must Shastra Baba. I must serve. Nama Shastra Kavitarani Kanipunam Visara Goswami. Then even Shastra Siddhanta is in the line of this Mahaprabhu's life. You understand? Where it is? They are going also with Jagna. Nonsense. Fools.
That's so one poster, you know, advertising on the
yes.
High school, Ashram Vedat Jagya.
Yes, what big is? Advertisement in paper, daily newspaper, everywhere, collecting so much money, people are giving money. Lakhs, lakhs, lakhs of rupees. Ways. All fools, rascals, don't going on.
Ashram Vedat is you push the horse in front of the army, right? This is Ashram Vedat Jagya. You send a horse before your army and then you follow and then you
walk. They were doing other jugas, the kings. Kings, are there kings now? All Sudras. Kings, why you have some what is all forbidden?
They'll kill a poor horse.
Yeah. commit sin for all sin like this sin. Sruta means this study, knowledge, scholarship. Education, this material education, material scholars learn. Those who have acquired so many degrees from so many universities, they are naturally very proud of them. They are not humble at all. So they cannot understand. Krishna says, Sarvicha Vedi Angeva Vidyaka. All Vedas I am to be known. Sarva Vedanta Sara, this Srimad Bhagavata. This Srimad Bhagavata is the essence of all Veda Vedantas. So, what does Srimad Bhagavata say? Srimad Bhagavata says Krishna is the Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is Bhagavan. And this description of different incarnations, avatara yasankhya hari sattva nidhi dija jatha vidyasana kulyasar sasrasa. This first kind of Srimad Bhagavata. There are innumerable incarnations, Lord Hari. Innumerable. Some famous incarnations, Sukadeva Goswami of Vedanta. This is some famous incarnations in Srimad Bhagavata. And Matsya Avatar is one of them. But so-called Vedavadis, they cannot understand how Krishna is there. Sarvicha Vedi Angeva Vidyo, all Vedas I am to be known, Krishna says. But so-called Vedavadis, they cannot understand. They can see Krishna. How Krishna is there? Because Krishna never revealed himself before such clubbed up fellows. Those are not devotees. Those are devotees, completely surrender unto Krishna, engaged in loving service. They have gotten mercy of Krishna, and Krishna reveals himself before them. But though Krishna is there in Veda, these people cannot understand. So, first thing we should understand what is Veda. That you know by Veda.
Knowledge?
He says knowledge, one word. Yes, what knowledge? Material knowledge.
Both material, all knowledge given by the Lord for the
material and spiritual upliftment.
Yeah. This word Veda, how it is derived?
Vid, no?
Yes. Vid dhatu, verbal root is vid. You understand? From this dhatu, verbal root vid, karma vachya or pratyaya, then it's Veda, the Sanskrit. Vid dhatu means to know, to realize. Meaning of vid dhatu. You understand? That's Veda. Veda yati dharma brahman sa Veda. One of the definitions of Veda. Vedayati dharma brahman sa Veda. In Veda Shastra, Nitya dharma, do you understand? And Parabrahma tattva. There is Nitya dharma tattva and Parabrahma tattva in Vedic literature, in Veda. That Shastra that speaks about this Nitya dharma and Parabrahma tattva, that's Veda. Understand? Vedayati dharma brahma sa Veda. Jiva Goswami, since Jiva Goswami is authority, in his Tattva Sandarbha, he has given a definition of Veda. Anadi Siddha Sarva Purusa Paramparasu Sarva Laukika Laukika Jnana Nidana Tvat Aprakrita Vachan Lakhyana Veda. Do you understand? Jiva Goswami has given his authority. In Tattva Sandarbha, this is definition of Veda. Anadi Siddha Sarva Purusa Paramparasu Sarva Laukika Laukika Jnana Nidana Tvat Aprakrita Vachan Lakhyana Veda. That means Veda comes from Supreme Personality Godhead, Sachidananda Vigraha, who is cause of all causes, Parameshwara, Ishwara Parama, Ishwara of all Ishwaras, from time immemorial, we cannot trace out its beginning, because Supreme Lord is eternal, so Veda is also eternal. And it comes down here through bona fide Vedic disciplic succession. You understand? Sarva Purusa Parampara, it's called a Parampara, disciplic succession. And here, Laukika, Sarva Laukika, Laukika Jnana Nidana, that's Aprakrita Vachana. It's an Aprakrita, it's not Prakrita Vachana, it's not material. It's transcendental. That comes from Krishna, Supreme Personality. It's transcendent. Aprakrita Vachana, Kara. Do you understand? It's transcendent. As you say, yes, Veda, all are there, it's Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda. Karma Kanda section, Jnana Kanda section, it's all material, that's all life. Still, when it has come out from the Supreme Lord, it's also, in that sense, transcendental, not material. When you relate everything to the Lord, how it will be material? That's your tattva. So those who are this Paramahansas, very, very elevated devotees, Kejwela Paramahansa, Paramahansa Chudamani, they never see anything material. Their vision is not. They think everything is spiritual, because everything has come out emanated from Krishna, related to Krishna. And Krishna is the only relationship, Mukhya Samanda. And Veda said that thing. Veda teaches three tattvas, samanda, avideya, prayodana. Samanda tattva means relationship, avideya tattva is bhakti, prayodana is prema. Three tattvas. So, sarvaicha vedi angami vidya, in all Vedas I am to be known, Krishna says. So samanda means everything is related to Krishna. When there is a question of this relationship with Krishna, how can it say? Dear devotees, those who have gotten mercy of Krishna, Mukta Mahapurus, liberated souls, Mahapurus, Mahatmas, and their district succession, Vyaprakuta, transcendental, Sabda Brahma, and three Veda. Understand? That Jiva Goswami says. And it comes in. Gana Paita respects Guru Parampara by hearing process. Therefore, the other name of Veda is Shruti. Shruti means by hearing. And Shruhiya. Disciples to hear this Veda, Tattva, Veda. You understand? Through hearing from Guru, Acharya. And it is received in this hearing process. That's other name is Shruti. There are four divisions of Veda. You understand? Four divisions are there. What are those four divisions? Hello?
Rig Sama Yajur Atharva. Rig Sama Yajur Atharva.
There are four Vedas.
There are four Vedas.
Sambandha.
Four divisions, Sangeeta, Brahmana, Aranyaka, Upanishad, or Vedanta. These are four divisions. Understand? You should be a student of Veda. That's to understand. Then how can we come to? Because we are studying this, all essential Veda is Srimad Bhagavatam. Unless you know this, how can you read Srimad Bhagavatam? Essential Veda. What sort of student you are? Don't feel embarrassed. Tell me, President, all experience. Four divisions, Sangeeta, Brahmana, Aranyaka, Upanishad, Vedanta. So what is Sangeeta? In Sangeeta portion, all mantras are there. You understand? It's a Supta Samasti. Aggregate of all suktas, mantras, Vedic hymns. You understand? That is Sangeeta portion. Mantra. You understand? Brahma portion, generally, written in prose part, and in this portion, different types of jagya vidhi, you understand? Different types of jagya sacrifices are mentioned, and what jagya, what type of jagya, what jagya, how you can perform, what mantra you order, what is the procedure, all these things are mentioned in Brahman portion of the Veda. Our Aranyaka portion, this Aranyaka portion is one of the parts of Brahman portion, Brahmanansa, and it's written in forest, the rishis, Vedic acharyas, stay in forest in their asamas, they have written, that name is Aranyaka. The last thing is Upanishad or Vedanta. This is the topmost portion and yes, topmost portion of Veda. This is Upanishad of Vedanta. And many Veda Upanishads are there. Many, many Upanishads. So out of them there, say 108 Upanishads. And some say out of this 108 Upanishads are most famous. Then Sangeeta is divided, subdivided into two parts, Bhagavad Nishtha and Vedanta Nishtha. Brahman portion also subdivided into three parts, Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Upasana Kanda. Three parts in Brahman portion. The Karma Kanda section, Jnana Kanda section, though is a Nartam Das Thakur says, Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Sakali Vishar Bhanda. Amrita Kulya Devakha, Nana Dhani Sadaphira, Kadarja Bhakhyana Kare, Tadana Adapadita. Vaishnava Acharya, Nartam Das Thakur says, Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Sakali Vishar Bhanda is poisonous. If someone accepted as Amrita, Nektar, so he will only undergo different species of life, lots of species of life here in this material world and all the cycle of birth and death. We cannot tell you. Still, this is the portion of Veda, कर्मकांड ज्ञानकांड For some of Veda and Veda comes out from the breathing of the Supreme Lord. So in Tattva we can say it is also Bhagavad Gita related to Bhagavan. Similarly, Jnana Kanda is Brahma Pratipadaka, Bhagavata Pratipadaka, two divisions in Jnana Kanda is that. Speaks of Brahma, emerging in Brahma, Mukti, Purusha, Mukti, and Bhagavata Pratipadaka also there. And another is Upasana Kanda. In Upasana Kanda, how to do Bhagavad Upasana, Devata Upasana, you understand? Worship of Devatas. And Devatas are the, what is that? Bhaktas, devotees. They are carrying out the order of the Supreme Personal Godhead, and they are also Bhagavan Shakti or Vibhuti. So, Upasana Kanda in that sense is also relating to Supreme Lord. Mahaprabhu came, which Krishna himself, from whom Veda comes, breathing of the Lord is Veda. What he says about Veda? So-called Vedavadis, this Brahmavadis, Mahavadis, impersonalis, they boast that they know Veda, they are known of Veda. They are great scholars and they are very popular, proud, because they know Veda. We know Veda, do you understand? Nobody knows Veda. But Mahaprabhu came defeated. Mahaprabhu, Krishna himself, from whom Veda comes, he came as an acharya to teach real the teaching of Veda. Sarvecha Vedyam Vipetya, not Veda. I am Krishna is doing, Mahaprabhu is doing. But so the Veda Vadis, very fond is Brahmavadis, Mayavadis, personalities, though they say, proclaim proudly that we know Veda, we are Vedavadis, Vedantist. You understand? But Mahaprabhu defeated. Mahaprabhu said, they speak about Brahma, Brahma, Brahma. You understand? Brahma, Brahma, Brahma. They don't speak Krishna. And they say there is no name of Krishna. Yes. Mahaprasa. Veda Purana kahe Brahma nirupa. Sei Brahma Gurupastu Ishwar Lakshya. Brahma sabde kahe punna swing Bhagavan. Swing Bhagavan Krishna Sastra. Bhagavan samanda bhakti avidhaya hoy. Prema prayodan vede dini vasna hoy. Vedari sakala sastra Krishna. Mukhya samanda. Tavgyana anusangye jaya maya bhakti. मुख्य गौण वृत्ति किंबा अन्य वृत्ति देखे वेद प्रतिज्ञा कर कहे कृष्ण महापुरुष तपद लीला सिक्स चैप्टर यू फाइंड इट महापुरुष अथॉरिटी फ्रॉम होम सुप्रीम अथॉरिटी फ्रॉम होम वेद कम्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ वेद सुप्रीम अथॉरिटी ऑफ वेद बट यू से ब्रह्म दैट इज ब्रॉड वस्तु ईश्वर लक्षण एंड इज स्वयं भगवान That Brahma, Parabrahma, Supreme Brahma is Swayam Bhagavan. And Swayam Bhagavan Krishna Sastra. And in all Vedic literature, Brahma, Swayam Bhagavan is Krishna. But you say Brahma, that's Krishna. So, you say Brahma, Brahma is there in Veda, so that is Krishna. But you cannot understand how Krishna is. Sarvecha Vedi, Anga Pravetya. Now Veda, I am to be known, but so called Brahma Bhadi, popular fellows. They cannot trust because they are not devotees. Krishna is not real himself in all that. So they cannot trust. Mahaprabhu, the authority, the supreme authority, he said, What you say, Rama is Swayam Bhagavan, Swayam Bhagavan is Krishna. All Vedic literature, there is proof. Proof in it, Vedic evidence. And Veda three tattvas. Veda, there are three tattvas. Veda speaks about three tattvas. Samana Tattva, Vidya Tattva, Prayodana Tattva. Sanamana is relationship, Adhideva is bhakti, Prayodana is prema, love. Vedani Sapala Sastra Krishna Mukhya Samanda, Tavgyana Amsambhi Jayamaya. In all the literature, one Samanda, that is Krishna. Then Sam Sarvasya Prabhava Matta Sarvam Prabhati, Iti Matta Vajindramani, Bhava Samanda. Krishna said that in the Gita, I am the source of all emanations, everything is emanated from me, source of creation, everything. So, whatever you see and find, so everything, everybody is related to Krishna. Yes. So this is Samanda. Krishna is the only relationship and chief relationship. Mukhya Samanda. Tar Jnane Anusangi Jaya Maya Vanda. To know and understand Krishna. In Tattva is the aim of this. Purpose of this reality actually human life. The purpose of this reality actually is not to understand. Know and understand Krishna Tattva. Janma Karmanchane Jivyam Yehu Jovidhi Tattva Taha Tekta Adeyahu Punar Janma Neki Samangi Tattva. For chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, my bhak, my appearance and my activities of leaders are all transcendental, it's not material. One who knows it in truth, in Tattva, after quitting his body, you go to me, you never come down here, no rebirth. That means you never come down here to the material world and take birth again. That means that is the success of this human birth. To understand Krishna is tattva. Beler Bhavijyan keval kohe Krishna ki tar jnane anusangi jaya maya. Unless one understands Krishna, getting this rarely achieved human birth, someone cannot understand Krishna in tattva. His human birth is void. But he cannot fulfill the purpose of the birth. Again and again you fall down here in the material world and undergo lots of spaces of life. Yes, he cannot deliver. He cannot enter into the Lord's kingdom. Even Jovi Gita Tattva Deham Punarjanna Naiti Samanda. Arjuna and non-being Tattva, they have no Punarjanna, no rebirth. He is quitting his body, must go. No Punarjanna. Tadavan Tattva Gyanta Vishwati Tadavan Tattva. Navijana Tattva Na Tattva Chevanti Deva. Many times. Many times, repeatedly Krishna said in the Gita. Tadavan Tattva Gyanta Vishwati Tadavan Tattva. Navijana Jitattva na Tattva Chevanti. Doesn't understand, know me in Tattva, Chevanti fall down here. He cannot enter into my kingdom. Tattvam Tattva Kyanta Vishyate Balvantara. And knowing me in Tattva, understanding me in Tattva, he is allowed, he can enter into my kingdom. You understand? So the purpose of this, really achieving human birth is to understand Krishna in Tattva. And three tattvas are there in Veda, Samanda, Prayodhana, Abhideva, Prayodhana tattva. One understands this Krishna, he knows these three tattvas. And he achieves success in his human, of his human birth, human life, and no more coming down here, entering Lord's kingdom and stop there. That is the purpose. Mukhya Gauna Bhuti Kimba Namati Rekhe. Veder Pratijna Keval Kohe Krishna. Whatever is the Mukhya or Gauna, primary or secondary, Anna Vijireva. Everything, all, everything that is said in Veda, it relates to Krishna. Nothing else. Sarvicha Medhyanga Veda. But so-called Veda Bhadis, so-called Veda Pandits, they cannot understand. And they can see and find out that Krishna is there. Krishna is there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, known as Seventh Goswami, Krishna Acharya, Vedic Acharya, he gives fame. The essence of all Vedanta Darshana. he gives 10 tattvas, you understand, that is there in all ten of the Vedantas. Amnaya praha tattvam harimiha param sarva saktim rasabdhim tadbhinam sastra jivam prakriti pavaritam tadbhinam prasastra bhava bheda bheda prakasam sakalam atihare sadhanam suddha bhaktim sadhyam tatpriti mivetki padisati janam Gaura Chandra Swayam Saha. You understand? These are Dasamula Tattva. 10 primary tattvas. All made Vedanta. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vedic Acharya, gives this first thing. First tattva is Pramana Tattva, Amanaya Tattva, and 9 others are Prameya Tattva. You understand? Hey. You understand? You have written. Amanaya means Veda. Amanaya means Veda, Shruti. So Vedic proof is chief proof, mukhya pramana, understanding paratattva. Vedic proof, this is Amanaya. Second thing is Hariniya Paramam Sarva Sattingra Sabdhi. Second thought, fourth. Second thing, Lord Hari is Paramam Tattva, Supreme Truth. Third thing, Sarva Sattingra, Lord Hari is all powerful. Fourth thing, Rasabdhi, Hari, Lord Hari, is the essence of all mellows, rasa, rasa-vaisa. Then fifth thing comes, tad-vina-sastra-jeeva, prakruti-kavalitam, tad-vina-sastra-bhava. Two types of jeevas are there, baddha and mukta, conditioned and liberated. And these two types of jeeva are differentiated parts of Lord Hari, vivinansa. Sixth thing, this Baddha Jeeva's conditioned souls, they are conditioned by Maya, and travel by Maya, Maya Baddha, they are known as Maya Baddha. Seventh thing is Mukta Jeeva, liberated, they are liberated from Maya, process of Maya, Maya Mukta. Eighth thing comes, Veda Veda Pagasam, Sakala Mapihare Sadhana Sudha Bhakti. Cheat and achieve, both material and spiritual world. Do you understand? Cheat and achieve, two types, manifestation. All two types of all these manifestation are bheda bheda achintya bheda bheda pradasa. Inconceivably one and different. Do you understand? Achintya bheda bheda pradasa varari. Ninth is, sadhana Sudha Bhakti. Sudha Bhakti, pure devotion, it only means sadhana to approach Lord Hari or get Lord Hari. Tenth thing is sadhyam tattviti meveti padisati jana gaura chandra swayam sa. Tenth is priti tattva, sadhya tattva, and Sādhya tattva is Krishna priti, love of Krishna. This is 10th verse. It's original mula sikhya. Dasa mula sikhya. 10 original tattvas in Veda. Vedic Acharya, Vaishnava Acharya, known as 7th Goswami, Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur, authority says so. Another Shastra is there, known as Vedanga. We follow. Another Shastra is there, known as Vedanga. One should understand this Shastra also, because this is also related to Veda. Those who want to study Veda, they should know this Shastra. Then it will be easy on their part to study Veda. There are 6 Vedanga Shastras. 6. You know? Huh?
Samhitas? Brahma Samhita?
Bolo, bolo, bolo.
Brahma Samhita? Manu Samhita?
What is that, Baba? Samhita, I already said. And I say about this division, Sabeda, four divisions, Sangita, Vasa is Sangita. Brahman, Aranya, Upanishad, I want to explain. This is Vedanga. Six Vedanga Shastras. Sikya, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Nirupta, Chanda, Jyotisha. Understand? Understand? These are six Vedanga Shastras. Sikya, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Nirupta, Chanda, Jyotisha. What is Sikya? Sri Vishnu Sutta Niyankara Swaradir Jnanaya Sikya. Understand? That means the Sikya Shastra speaks about the Suptami mantras that will be uttered. Understand? While receiving Lord Vishnu, Vishnu mantras. And what is correct? Pronunciation. Correct pronunciation. You understand? It should be pronounced correctly. Otherwise, mantra will never be effective. It will produce some different effect. Yes. If it wrongly pronounced. So the Sikya, Vedanga Shastra teaches that. Then second Vedanga Shastra is Kalpa. What is Kalpa? Ankurupya Kalpaha. That means, in this Shastra, Kalpa Shastra, Vedanga Shastra teaches how to perform Yajna, Jagatriya. You understand? And what is first to be done, the next ritual performances of Jagat. That is called background, that is grammar. Sadhutvasya background. Word, sentence, phrases, idioms like this, and things are there. How, what is correct, how is incorrect, what is incorrect. All this is taught in this background portion. And Jiva Goswami has written Harinamamrita background. Do you understand? Harinamamrita background. That's he has related everything to Harinam, big book. And that's a Shastra, background Shastra, Vaishnava should read it. Then comes Nirupta, Padarthasya Niruptam. The words, words or phrases used in Veda. And what are the meanings of that words and phrases? That is Nirupta, that means that should be dictionary. Then Chanda, Mantranam Chanda. Every mantra, Shruti mantra, Veda mantra, is written in an order. That is order, rhetoric. You understand? We say rhetoric. And that order is known as Chanda. And different Chandas are there. That is a Gayatri Chanda. Anushtubha Chanda, so many Chandas are there. And that mantra will be pronounced and uttered in that way, rhetoric way. Otherwise, that will be wrong. So this Chanda Shastra teaches that way. Then, sixth Vedanga Shastra is Jyotisha, astronomy, astrological. This is Mahoshavadi Samayasya Jyoti. So, what day, what planet, what graha, what nakshatra, what tithi, what mahotsava festival will take place, it's all calculation, the calculations are there. And Mujas, they calculate according to Jyoti Shastra, Vedanga Shastra, and they determine it, yes. And this tomorrow is Ram Navami. The appearance of Lord Ram, this nakshatra, this graha, this time, this moon time, and that Mahotsav festival will be there. That Vishnu Parva Mahotsav, and solar lunar eclipse of energy come out, is all calculation. This is Shastra, Jyoti Shastra. These are six Vedanga Shastras. And they are related to Veda. So it's a Vedanga Shastra. And those who are Vedic students, they should know this. Then it is easy on their part to study Veda. There are Vedanga Shastras there. Another thing we are saying is that so called Vedavadis, they cannot. They say there is no name of Krishna in Veda. Yes, they say. No name of Krishna. That they cannot. That they are saying our Shyama Savarana, you know, Veda, which is there. And also, one another question is there, why? Why it is given this, this we say karma kanda, jnana kanda section. Nartam Das Thakur says, Vishir Bhanda, karma kanda, jnana kanda, sapali Vishir Bhanda. This Vishir Bhanda, the poet must know, why is it there? Gauna Phala, why in Vedas this Gauna Phala, the second things are given there. Sarvincha Vedi, Angiva Vidya, in all Vedas I am to be known. Krishna says, I am to be known, and Krishna is only known through bhakti. Bhakti ananga vijanati, bhakti astvaranaya bhakti. Only through bhakti, Krishna is to be known. This is mukhya. Why all these secondary things are there in Veda? Why it is given there in Veda? This question is there. Why?
Not everyone can have direct access to devotion, so yes. They are induced by temporary promises to start on the path of worship, and gradually their consciousness can be elevated.
Yeah, there are Bhaktivinoda Thakur said that two types of jivas are there, mukta jiva, baddha jiva, isn't it? Baddha jiva. For Baddha Jivas, conditioned soul, they cannot understand it. Well, their consciousness is a low consciousness, and sunken consciousness like this. So the Baddha Jivas, they are two types. There are two types.
Conditioned jivas?
Yes.
Civilized and uncivilized.
Civilized and uncivilized. Udita viveka, anudita viveka. Bhaktivinoda Thakura said in Jayavadhyam. Udita viveka, anudita viveka. Viveka means conscientiousness, conscience. Conscientiousness. What is it?
Discrimination.
Discrimination. Conscientiousness. Udita, anudita. Risen, not risen. Conscientiousness, risen, not risen. Two types. Udita viveka, anudita viveka. In the jivas in whom this condition, soul, jivas, in whom this conscientiousness is not risen, that is, they are known as anudita, anudita viveka baddha jiva. You understand? Anudita viveka baddha jiva. They are mainly this lower species of the dhyana, human species. And human species like animals, birds, beasts. They cannot understand about soul and super soul, Bhagavan, they never make an effort to understand this. You understand? They are known as anudita viveka baddha jiva. And udita viveka baddha jiva. This baddha jiva, but their conscientiousness is rising. They inquire about it. himself, the devil, his inquiry. What is our soul with these? Who am I? Why have I been suffering like this? As you said, they are conscious, they are not careless. So they are udita viveka. They inquire about this paramartha. So those who are, they see, anudita srenya, their conscientiousness has not risen, they don't inquire about it. The supreme truth. For them, this section is there. Secondary sections in Veda. Because they always want, such person, they want one tangible result. Unless they get something tangible, they can't act on it. You understand? They want some tangible. Otherwise, they won't perform something, pious activity, punya karma sadkarja. For them, this Gauna Phala, the secondary portions are there. But that is not the purpose of Veda. It's not the purpose of Veda of the anudita viveka. Human beings, manava. Be content with it. Now, our aim is, goal is to understand Krishna and know Him, understand and get Him. And that's not the purpose of Veda, that this anudita viveka. Human beings be content with this. Secondary things. Thereby, get something tangible, perform some Vedic rituals. They will be interested in Veda, develop their interest. And thereby, they will inquire more and more. And if someone is fortunate, they will meet a sadhu, guru, and inquire about the Supreme Truth. Yes? So you get sadhu mercy. Then comes the mukhya phala, the chief result. And from Gauna, from secondary, you elevate it to chief. And gradually you develop ruchi, taste, and attraction for Krishna katha and Krishna bhakti. That is the chief thing in Veda. Understand? Therefore, these secondary things are there. Next thing is there. I was saying that day, how in Veda, this Krishna is there, Radha Krishna is there, name of Radha Krishna is there also in Veda, Veda Shastra. Krishnaya Vasudevaya Deva Vinandana Yacha. Krishna Sandarbha, Krishna Sandarbha. Jiva Goswami has quoted this thing. This Sama Upanishad Vakya, Devakinandan Krishna, Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devakinandan. These names are there. Jo Asau Param Brahma Gopala. It's from Gopala Tapini, Upanishad. Upanishad, topmost portion of Veda. Jo Asau Param Brahma Gopala. It is Gopala Tapini. How do you say that? No, name of Krishna. Nanda Nandana Jasodasta Nandaya Tamavasyam Param Brahma. Nanda Nandana Jasodasta Nandaya, the son of Nanda Maharaj, who sucks the breast of Jasoda Mata, bodily complexion is Tamavasyam. What is that?
Blackish you like a Tamal tree.
Yeah, blackish you like a Tamal tree is Param Brahma Krishna. It is there. Śrīmad-Bhāgavata is essence of all the literature, sarva-vedānta-sāra. Guḍam param brahma manusya-līnam jesaṁ grahānāvasitīti sākhyā janmitraṁ paramānandam purnam brahma-sanātanam. 10th canto of Bhāgavata, 7th canto of Bhāgavata. with essence of all Vedavita. The Purna Brahma itself, Purna Brahma, Supreme Brahma, Param Brahma, is Krishna. Jamitra Paramananda Purna Brahma Sanatana. So how to say that there is nothing? Again, Jatravati Nam Krishna Kyam Param Brahma Marakrutihi Vishnu Purana. Param Brahma, Purna Brahma. Vedanam Samvedasmi, I was saying that. Krishna says that Vedanam Samvedasmi. This is Samveda in all the Vedas. Why says? Why says?
Because you will reveal to us today the mantras of Samaveda with Hare Krishna.
Yes. Samveda speaks about Krishna, Radha Krishna. Yes. Therefore, in Veda Krishna says, Veda and Samveda. In all Vedas, I am Samveda. Sarvecha Veda, Amuiva Vidya. Though Krishna is to be known in all Vedas, but specifically says, Veda and Samveda. I am in all Vedas, I am Samveda. Because in Samveda, is very confidential. In Samveda, there is Radha and Krishna, spoken about Radha and Krishna. Here, Samveda Mantra, 1487, Abhi Prabhupati Girindramarcha Jatha Vide Sunu Satyaswa Satpati Abhi Abhilakhya Gopati Gira Indramarcha Jatha Vide Saha Jivaniti Jani Sunu Satya Tuttanam Gatasya Angi Bhutam Satkarmanadatam Satpati Satyapa Sadamparatam. You understand? This mantra is there. In Samveda. 1487 mantra. See what does it say? It says the very authorities in their Bhasha they have said, Gopati, say, Gopati. Satpati, Abhi, Gopati, Girindramarchaha, Videsu, Satyasu, Satpati, Abhirakyati, Gopati. You understand? Gopati means what? Go means cattle, go, cow. Pati means Swami, Master. Is what? Is Govinda, is Gopal. Prakarsana, Pujaya Prakarsana means Pujaya Girasastya Jatha Videswaha. That means Gopati means Krishna. It's Govinda Gopal, it's Krishna. Prakarsana, that means is to be offered prayer with humility. It's Govinda Gopal, therefore is known as Gopati. Prakrishna. And his Satpati, strong husband, Satpati, supreme husband, Parampati, and one should offer prayer with him. Heart filled with bhakti, bhakti pruta. This mantra says, again, another mantra in Samveda, 1170. Jadindra Chitra Mahindra Nasti Tvadatam Madriva Radha Radhastanna Vida Dvastuvaya Hasta Astyavara. This mantra is there. The 1170 mantra in Samveda. Jadindra means Jad Indra combined together is Jadindra. Who is the supreme proprietor? Not Jadindra. It's what? It's Krishna. Aham sarvasya prabhava, mata sarvam prabhava. So Krishna. It means Krishna. Who is the supreme proprietor? Everything belongs to his. Everything is his property. Tadava madriva. Tadatan madriva. That means He destroys all sinful reactions, papa vinashaya. Prajiva vaitava dharma. You understand? Second verse of Srimad Bhagavatam says, Prajiva vaitava dharma, that is Bhagavata dharma, speaks dharma that is propagated by Bhagavan is known as Bhagavata dharma, is Prajiva vaitava, it is not cheating dharma, there is no question of dharma, artha, kama, moksha. You understand? One destroys Prajita Karma Dharma. That Bhagavata Dharma is propagated of that Dharma is Supreme Personality Godhead Krishna. Yes, it's Krishna that says. And he destroys all these desires of Dharma Artha Kama Mukhya from the heart of the devotee. Therefore, devotee's heart. Purified heart, so in the heart of devotee, the lotus feet of that Supreme Krishna manifested. And this mantra says, let that lotus feet of Krishna be manifest in my heart. Mantra says, Toya dāta, dātavam, yahasmin loke, in this world, yahajagata, yahasmin loke, ma, Ma means our, there is nobody. Ours, you are only ours. Or our. That is this. Then says, Radhastana, Viladas Uhayahas Tyavara. Radhastana, Radha, Tatatma. This name of Radha is there. Yes. Radhastana means Radha, Tatatma. That means, O Radhe. He says, O Radhe. We are yours. And Paramapurusartha, Supreme Purusartha, is pure bhakti. By the mercy of yours, or Adi, one can have Param Bhakti, Supreme Bhakti. That mantra says. Then Ubhavyam Hastabhyam. Avara prajaccha. That means Ubhaya means both, Radha and Krishna. It's both Ubhaya means both. Ubhaya. Hasta dvaya means hands of both, Radha and Krishna. Is Paramapurusartha prema dhana gives prema dhana. This mantra says. Some Veda mantra says, Krishna is the destroyer of dharma, artha, kama, mukhya, desire for dharma, artha, kama, mukhya, and kripaya, out of mercy, and the purified heart. In the heart there is no desire for kama, dharma, artha, kama, mukhya, and pure bhakti is there. He manifests himself, or his lotus feet are manifest. So in this world, Yajagato, he is the supreme proprietor, everything is his property, nobody is proprietor. Then he says, O Radhe, O Krishna, O Radhe, both Radha and Krishna, and the hands of both of you, let me give prema, supreme purusartha. This is the meaning of the mantra. How to say that there is no mention of Krishna in Veda? So many instances are there. You understand how Krishna is there. But so-called Vedavadi, they cannot understand. Because Krishna never revealed himself. Because they are not devotees. They are puffed up with their belief. Scholarship done. They are not humble. Akinchana-pocharam. They are not akinchana, it's kinchana, they are pandava. So Krishna never manifest. Krishna is covered up. How can we understand? Only devotee, Vaishnava. Go on to explain one verse, it will take days together. Yes, days together. What to speak of? Half an hour, 1 hour. Days together.
If you want to explain wonders from Srimad Bhagavatam, it contains six constraints. So
then, even as a student of Bhagavatam, it seems like he would need to get continue to get tutored and taught by a Brahmana to know more and more and more.
Yeah. Vaishnava, Ja Bhagavata for Vaishnava. Vaishnava is Pakka Brahmana, Paramatma. Yes. Ja Bhagavata for Vaishnava. Ekanta Ashraya for Chaitanya. Though, I call say Vaishnava, Tani Bhagavata.
In that association, all is revealed.
And completely surrendered. Only by bhakti you can understand Bhagavata. Cannot understand Bhagavata, I didn't have your material scholarship, learning, of taking help of the commentaries given by many commentators. Only bhakti. You have to explain bhakti. Take shelter. Mahaprabhu. Ekanta Ashraya Kara, Chaitanya Chara, Ja Bhagavata Vaishnava. Go and appreciate Bhagavata, embodiment of Bhagavata, Bhakta Bhagavata, the devotee of Chaitanya, and study Bhagavata. Hear Bhagavata, study Bhagavata. Then you can understand Bhagavata. Sarva Vedanta, this is all there. All these things come up. When we are going, I explain one verse, or about this one line, but one sentence. But so many things are there, isn't it? So many.
Guru Maharaj?
Yes.
How can we understand that Vedic aphorism, Eko Bahusham?
Yes.
The one sham became many.
Yes. Eko Bahusham. You are one, became many. Expanded. Expansions, yes. These expansions. Unlimited expansions. Eko Bahusya. Yes. Unlimited expansions. Unlimited forms. Achyutam, Anantam. Achyutam, Anadim, Anantarupam. Brahma Samhita says. Achyutam, infallible, Anadi, without beginning, Anantarupam. Unlimited form. Eko Bahusya. Yes. Huh? Understood. Because this so-called Maya Bhagavata, they cannot understand. They are material thoughts. They can all like this piece of paper. You tear it, piece of paper. Then it loses its power. Then it becomes formless.
Nirakar.
And becomes Bahusyam, unlimited. Expanded and become unlimited form, then loses its own form, become formless. Rascals. Though Krishna expands into an unlimited form, never loses its original form. Always original form. Yeah, that you cannot understand. Mudhas. They are mudhas. They are mudhas. Rascals. How can you understand this? Avadananti mang mudha. Yes, sir. The Murha, they cannot, they deride me. They cannot understand. Such a great scholar, Sarvam Bhattacharya, knows such shastra, Brihaspati incarnation, incarnation Brihaspati. You will never find, up till now, there no such a scholar. Yes, like Sarvam Bhattacharya. He cannot understand. What to speak of others? Yes. And Gopinath Acharya said that thing, oh, you are such a great Pandit, you know Shastra, Shastravid, but you cannot understand, Ishwar Krupanai, you have not gotten mercy of God, therefore you cannot, then gotten, hey, stop your mouth, Gopinath, stop your mouth, what are you saying, you have gotten mercy, I have not gotten, you got angry, you see, you got angry. Oh, I cannot understand. Such a Pandit. When all right, Arubi Krupa Hobi. He became disgusted. Sarav hi te bijavapana, I am just sowing seed in a barren land. Land is barren, not fertile. I'm sowing seed, I'm a fool. I'm sowing seed in a barren land. How will fructify? When you get the mercy of pointing out Mahaprabhu, when you get his mercy, then you can understand. And he got mercy. Mahaprabhu, you understand. When this verse came up, Atma Rama Samuna Indra Gantha, Parvati Ahitmi Bhakti Ahitmi Guna Bhutan Hari, famous verse in Simal Hadu. Mahaprabhu quoted this verse. Then, please explain this verse. You please first explain. He has great pandit and he has been proud. He has proud. He is grossed of his teaching sannyasis. He is so stuffed up, fellow. Proud fellow. And grossed of teaching sannyasis. And saying, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, young fellow, young boy, at a young age you have taken a sannyas. Very difficult to keep a sannyas in Kali Yuga. How can you keep a sannyas? And duty of sannyasi is to study Vedanta, hear Vedanta. But you are only chanting Hare Krishna, dancing on the street. How can you keep up sannyas at a young age? You study Vedanta from me. Mahaprabhu has a simple, innocent child. Yes, yes. I will study Vedanta, hear Vedanta from you. From whom Vedanta comes, such popular fellow, he wants to teach Vedanta to whom? Cannot understand. As an innocent child, Mahaprabhu sat down and he spoke on Vedanta for continuously 7 days, premises of Jagannath Puri temple. Mahaprabhu was only hearing, not saying anything. So on the last day, 7 days, he said, hey, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, do you understand what I say? You are not saying anything, asking any question, not asking any question. Then Mahaprabhu opened his heart. Oh, I understand the sutra very well. I understand the sutra, Vedanta sutra, the sutra formula you are quoting very well. But your vyakhya, your explanation is very difficult to understand. But explanation, yes. Nobody can understand sutra, therefore explanation, commentary is there. Explanation there. You said you understand sutra very well, and explanation, oh yes, because he is not explaining in a proper way. He is not proper authorized explanation, bona fide. He is concocted way. He says, Vedanta sutra is only surjir. Vyas has compiled Vedanta sutra. He is the compiler of Vedanta sutra. He has given commentary. This Bhagavata. Bhagavata is the commentary of Vedanta sutra. Who is the compiler? He has given commentary. You are not speaking about him. Bhagavata. You are quoting his own concocted Sarika Bhashya, compiled by Sri Pada Sankaracharya. In concocted Mahabharata Bhashya. So, listen to me. Vyasar sutra jane surjya kiran tumar vyakhya kala badal sam kore acharan. Vyas sutra, Vedanta sutra compared, Vyas is as a present at surjya, sun. But your explanation comment is like a black patch of cloud that covers up the sun. That is said. What? Oh yes. All right, you explain. And then this Atma Ramasya Munaya, this verse came up. And Mahaprabhu said, you explain first, then I will explain. Then he explained 9 different ways. Great pandit. 9 different ways he explained Atma Ramasya. Mahaprabhu said, oh, what you explain? Lani, Ami Jani. আমি সাক্ষাৎ বৃহস্পতি ভট্টাচার্য আমি জানি তুমি সাক্ষাৎ বৃহস্পতি শোক আখ্যা করিতে কার অদনাই শুনছি আই নো ইউ আর ইনকারনেশন বৃহস্পতি ভট্টাচার্য নোবডি ক্যান এক্সপ্লেন অ্যাজ ইউ এক্সপ্লেন দিস ভার্স নোবডি ক্যান এক্সপ্লেন বাট তুমি যে আখ্যা কইল পাণ্ডিত্য প্রতিভা ইয়ে শোক আছে আর অবস্থা আমাদের রেসপন্স আর স্কলারলি পাণ্ডিত্য মেটেরিয়াল স্কলারশিপ this verse speaks something else. And then Mahaprabhu explained in 18 different ways, without touching what he has said, Bhattacharya has said. 9 different ways, Mahaprabhu didn't touch it. Complete. Different explanation gave 18. And all these things. And he has, then he surrendered. Then so such a pandit cannot understand. Not so called by the Bahadis. Unless you have bhakti, how can you understand? How can you see, how can you find how Krishna is there and there? No Krishna is there. Yes, what I understand.
But then the mercy of we get, because this is such a big scholar, could not understand. And we are understanding through your mercy, because you are a representative of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then Mahaprabhu's mercy is understandable.
Are you flattering me?
No, with the mercy of Mahaprabhu.
Don't flatter me!
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is unlimited then. Huh? We can understand, such fools as we can get this understanding.
No, in mercy of my Guru, is dear devotee of Chaitanya. Yes. No, mercy can understand. Mukhaṁ karoti bhāsāḷam, paṅgulaṁ gaiti giri. Huh? Yes. Dumb, one is a dumb, cannot utter a word. You get mercy of Guru and Gauranga, you understand? Mukhaṁ karoti bhāsāḷam, paṅgulaṁ gaiti giri. Jatkrupa tam bande Sri Guru dinatāni, you get Guru Krupa. Mercy of Sri Guru and Gauranga's Krupa, then he may be a mukha, dumb. Getting that mercy, become an eloquent speaker on Veda. Eloquent speaker, yes. He may be a cripple, he may be a cripple, cannot move one inch. His mercy is so powerful that he can do mountaineering. Yeah, his mercy. Get the mercy. Hey.